yet another segment of Jesus Speaks. Before then, Lord Jesus Christ, take over. Holy Spirit, coach me. Let us be diminished. Let Jesus Christ increase. Let the word I will speak carry fire and power. Bless everyone that will listen to this or that is listening to this ministration. Bless them, bless their homes, bless everything that concerns them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Like I said, I'll be talking on a particular very important topic titled The Ten Lepers. Please turn your Bibles to Luke 17, verse 11 to 17, 2. I read. As Jesus continued on towards Jerusalem, he reached the border between Galilee and Samaria. As he entered a village there, 10 lepers stood at a distance. I want you to underline distance. Crying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." He looked at them and said, go show yourselves to the priest. Mark, go show yourselves. As they went, their leprosy disappeared. Mark, as they went. One of them, when he saw that he was healed, came back to Jesus, shouting, "Praise God, I am healed." He fell down on the grass at Jesus' feet, thanking him for what he had done. This was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, "Didn't I heal 10 men? Where are the other 9? Does only this one foreigner return to give glory to God?" And Jesus said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has made you well." Though it's about 6 verses, but the Holy Spirit opened my eye to show me 7 points, 7 lessons one has to learn from this. I want you to be very attentive because your life will never be the same again in Jesus' name after this ministration. First, what is leprosy? Leprosy is an infectious disease that affects the eyes, the respiratory organs, the mouth, and the skin. It's highly infectious. So people who have such disease are kept in isolation. It will never be a portion in the name of Jesus. So what are the lessons? One, because of the contagious nature of their disease, like I said, they were at a distance, but they were able to access Jesus. I tell people, distance is not a barrier to spiritual issues. That's why I will pray for somebody from here who is in Nigeria or South Africa, and Lord Jesus will heal him. Lord Jesus is everywhere at every time. He's omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent God. So don't give excuse that you are in a prison or you are somewhere, you are incarcerated, you are not able to access God. Remember, Joseph was said to have prospered in the prison. You can imagine a prisoner being said to be prosperous. We will all be prosperous in the name of Jesus. Lesson 2. They raised their voices. They were not shy of Jesus. Nowadays, people tend to be shy. They don't want to profess Jesus because of what society might think of them. If you go tenaciously to Jesus, you will get all you want. He's real. He's nearer to us than even what you see. So don't feel shy to confess that you belong to Jesus' family. If you confess him before men, he said, he will confess you before his Father. That will be your portion in the name of Jesus. Third point, they recognized Jesus from afar. That was the first time they met him, they saw him, but they recognized him. That tells you that anointing, Super anointing doesn't hide. It speaks. I remember a particular case. I was about 10 years ago. I was going to see a governor of a state. I was inside a cab. Lo and behold, we saw so many vehicles reversing. Then we thought they were armed robbers. That was in Nigeria. When we approached, we saw a stark naked, hefty madman with a big cutlass. He was about to smash our windscreen. His eyes met with mine. He took a bow like this and told all to go. True life story. The taxi man asked me, "Are you a native doctor? Why did the bad madman why did the madman salute you?" I told him, "Of course, I'm a native doctor, because Jesus is my father, and he's the creator of native doctors and everything that was created, and nothing was created that was not created by him. According to John 1, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. The Word became life. And the life became light of men, and darkness could not comprehend it, and can never comprehend it. The same light, we are told, created everything that was created, and nothing was created that was not created by the light. We are all family members of Jesus Christ. Can we shout hallelujah, hallelujah? Another point is, faith is necessary for your miracles to birth. I repeat, faith is necessary for your miracle to birth. Immediately they saw him, they said, "Help us. Help us." They ignited their faith. They believed so much, haven't heard of him, haven't heard of his faith, that if he makes pronouncement, you'll be healed. Most times, you can't succeed except you have strong faith. Cast your faith in Jesus, and everything will be added. They were convinced beyond a reasonable doubt that he will heal them. And that was why they shouted, "Heal us! Heal us!" The Bible states that it's only those who desire to be healed will be healed. You are healed in the name of Jesus from every affliction. I speak as a servant of God. Whoever that is under the influence of this ministration, receive their healing in the name of Jesus. Next point. Jesus is Lord and Master. They called him Master. They called him Lord. Remember, that was the first time they met him. That tells you the efficacy, the power behind our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible states that he sent his word, and his word healed off our destruction and diseases. The Bible also made us realize that by his stripes we were made whole. That is our portion in the name of Jesus. Next point, he said, "Go and show yourselves to the priest." Go and show yourselves to the priest. He spoke with authority. He spoke as the owner and director of the universe. All his power, all his statements carry power. He said he will watch his word to fruition, to permanent. Every word that he spoke and is still speaking till today will come to pass. He said, "Heaven and earth might pass away, but his word will never pass away." Jesus is not just powerful. He is power himself. All powers on earth, all powers below the earth, all powers in heaven have been given to him. Why not exercise hope and diligence and take him as your Lord and personal Savior? And all your problems will be taken of the past in Jesus' name. Amen. Next point. Miracles are in our hands. Remember, he told them, "Go and show yourselves to the priest. They were not cured before they left. It was on their way that they got healed. On their way, as they went. Remember I told you to mark it. So you have power to exercise. You have an obligation to fulfill. You don't just become docile. You have to activate your faith. If you were promised something, you don't become so laxative that you just allow the thing to come. Most time it won't come. You have to work out your miracle. It was as they went, they got healed. That will be your portion in the name of Jesus. Amen. They cured 10 people. One came back. Only one came back to show appreciation. No matter the little thing, no matter how small something is, a favor done to you by somebody, show appreciation. Thank him so that he can encourage you to do more. I tell people, 3 things that must not depart from your mouth. I'm sorry, please, and thank you. If you go tenaciously to these 3 points, I tell you, first, you hardly have trouble. Second, you have peace. Third, people will like you. And you just succeed and finish well. That is your portion in the name of Jesus. Another point there, he told the one that came back emphatically, your faith has made you whole. That means there's a difference. Remember, he was healed. That means there's a difference between being well, rather being healed, and being made whole. I think, from my own interpretation, that the other 9 people were cured of leprosy, but they were not made whole. Because they may have other ailments, which, of course, were not cured. So specifically, they were cured of leprosy. But the other one, like the only one that came back, was told, your faith has made you whole. Now, a holistic theory, a holistic approach to personal health, from his toes to his, from the crown of his head to his toes, was healed and made whole. That is your portion in the name of Jesus. You'll be made whole, provided you anchor on Jesus. You see, from experience, I've realized that we have to continually give our lives to Christ, continually make peace with him. That's why the Bible says, if you are at peace with the Lord, even your enemies will be at peace with you. It's when you are at peace with God, your footsteps will be ordered. That's why the Bible says, the footsteps of the righteous are ordered by God. There are so many advantages if you cling to Jesus. Cling to him. The race is not by the swift, neither the battle by the strong. But time and chance happen to them all. And Jesus provides the time and chance. He told us 365 times in the Bible, do not fear or afraid, because I will neither leave you or forsake you. He also, in the Bible, tells us that the afflictions of the righteous are numerous. But he is delivered from them all by God. The Bible tells us that surely they will gather, but because their gathering is not of the Lord, they will scatter. All this can only apply to you if you are in Christ Jesus. If you are yet to give your life to Christ, it's an opportunity for you to experience and enjoy this benefit. Remember, I keep on telling people, the smallest ant that entered Noah's ark was much more powerful than the biggest elephant that did not enter. Because the ant had covering. If you have covering of divinity, if you have covering by Trinity, your own is done. No matter what they do to you, nothing can happen. When they think they've oppressed you beyond reasonable doubt, you spring up from another side. And that is the portion of the name of Jesus. The greatest mistake anybody will make on earth, I tell, is to say no to Jesus. I repeat, the greatest mistake anybody will make on earth is to say no to Jesus. Remember the rich fool who had all the money he wanted and said he was going to start enjoying himself, forgetting the fact that God gave him power to make wealth. The best decision you make on earth is to say yes to Jesus. You have peace unprecedented. You look young anytime. You look vibrant. People can predict you. Become an enigma. If they are plotting here, you are springing off from this place because you sold yourself to Trinity. If you can remember, in the villages, there's what they call masquerades, especially people from the east or in Nigeria. Even all parts of the country, all parts of the world, you can bow for the so-called masquerade for protection. If a masquerade in the village can protect somebody, a masquerade that does not talk, not to talk of Jesus that created any masquerade. If you ensure your life in Jesus, he will reward you. Remember, he's the reward of those who diligently seek him. That is your portion in the name of Jesus. How do you say yes to Jesus? Very simple. The Bible says as follows. If you want to give your life to Christ, just repeat after me. Lord Jesus, for too long have I shut my door behind you. Please forgive me. I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart that you came to planet Earth, died for me because of my sins. You who knew no sin became sinner for my redemption and rose the third day from the grave, and you are alive and well. Again, I plead that you forgive every iota of sin I committed knowing or knowingly, and make me your son. Thank you, Jesus, because I'm a born-again Christian today. If you said that prayer after me, I want to congratulate you, because that was the best decision you've taken on earth. First, your name will be written in the book of life. God has written three things: when we are going to die, where we are going to die, and how we are going to die. People don't die because they are old. People don't die because they are young. It's a privilege to be alive. So many benefits. Like I said, you have peace unprecedented. You have a major covering, like the ant that entered Noah's ark. And of course, your life will never be the same again. That's the truth. I'm telling you from experience. Now you've accepted Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, we have to go to the next thing. Next stage is, God did not plan for anybody to be sick. No. His plan is for everybody he created to be strong in health, in wealth, and in soul. It's only devil that afflicts us with diseases. But if you know you are right before Christ, you will speak and they will obey you. You speak the word, divinity will back you up. That is the portion in the name of Jesus. If you are sick in any part of your body, I want you now to hold, to touch the place and repeat after me. Or better still, just say amen. Because I'm going to release the healing power of Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I cast out every affliction, every disease, every form of stagnation from the people, from my audience in the name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of paralysis. I cast out in the name of Jesus spirit of stagnation, moral decadence, all signs of COVID-19, Yes, Lord. I cast out every shown, real, perceived, or imaginary disease, liver-related, pain-related, rheumatism, arthritis, kidney problem, whatever sickness in your body, I cast out in the name of Jesus. I cast out in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Yes, I can see it. You are made whole. Yes, you are made whole. Yes. Holistic health. Holistic. I decree and declare as a servant of God that you made whole. Thank you, Lord, because I know divinity has endorsed this healing process in Jesus' name. Brethren, I want you to check yourself now. Whatever you couldn't do before, do it. Whatever you couldn't do before, you'll be able to do it now. Because the healing grace and power of Lord Jesus Christ has permeated your body. And of course, you will made whole. Now, you'll be made whole. I don't want you to stop there. I want you to identify a Bible-believing church. Go and start fellowshipping there so that you can grow in spirit, in godly things, and of course, you'll be able to finish well. Congratulations. I welcome you to the body of Christ. Your life will never be the same again. In Jesus' name. Thanks for listening. I remain Apostle Osbeta Jago. I want to hear your miracles. I want to read your miracles. Do us an email to pentiumministries@gmail.com. You can visit our website, www.pentiumministries.org. I repeat, pentiumministries.org. Our phone numbers remain +647 470 6555. Congratulations again, and God bless you. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. Thanks for listening.